Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. Today we will discuss reflex transistor on electronic admittance derivation. Now, in the previous lectures, I have explained the operation of reflex transistor. So basically, the reflex transistor of this arrangement works as an oscillator. So in the previous class, I have explained how the bunching parameter, the derivation of bunching parameter, the round trip transient time, DC round trip transient and theta 0 dash derivation, and the output power derivation and the maximum efficiency of reflex transistor as 22.7%. This is what we have discussed in the previous class. Today, now we will discuss the electronic admittance of reflex transistor. So, as you know that during the positive half cycle of the RF voltage, here the electron beam gets accelerated, so therefore it is traveling deeper into the repeller space. When the gap voltage is zero, the electron beam travels less into the repeller space. During the negative RF voltage here, the electron beam even travels less into the deeper space. So therefore, while coming back, these electrons form into bunches. While they arrive at this gap, they transfer their maximum kinetic energy to this gap. So during the retarding phase, of this cavity gap. So due to this, oscillations or RF output is obtained at this cavity gap. So in fact, RF output is taken from this cavity. So this is what we have discussed. Now we have derived the expression for current at the gap I2. And we have also derived the induced current in the gap. So let us start the session with the induced current. So therefore, the induced current at the cavity, the induced current at the cavity in phasor form. This is very important, in phasor form. So that is written as I2 induced. So that is we are writing in phasor form. So therefore, what is the current induced? What is the formula? Beta I2 I0 DC mean current J1 half. X dash is the fundamental component of amplitude of current induced. Because we are representing it as in phasor form, just add minus e power theta 0 dash. Just add this parameter, e power minus j theta 0 dash. Now, the voltage across the gap at time t2 in again phasor form is given as V2 is equal to V1 into e power minus j pi by 2. So therefore you have to remember these two equations to derive the electronic admittance of this reflex transistor. This is the current induced into the cavity. This is the voltage across the cavity gap. So what is the admittance? What is the electronic admittance? Current induced by voltage across the gap. Resistance is voltage by current. Conductance is current by voltage. So therefore, in fact, admittance is current by voltage. So therefore, the electronic admittance of reflex klystron is given as, so what is the simple formula? It is the ratio of electronic admittance, which is the ratio of current induced so by voltage across the gap. Voltage induced across the gap. So therefore, what is I2 induced in phasor form? 2 beta I 2 in fact 2 b 2 we have written in front I0, so J1 half x dash into e power minus j theta 0 dash by, so what is V2? V1 into e power minus j pi by 2. So therefore we will further reduce this into, so take e power minus j by 2 numerator, so therefore it is written as 2 beta I0, so J1 half x dash by V1 into e power of j pi by 2 minus theta 0 dash. So this is what. Now the bunching parameter, the bunching parameter of reflex klystron. We have derived the reflex klystron, we have derived the expression for this. So what is the expression? X dash is equal to, so beta I V1 by 2 V0 into theta 0 dash. So this is what we have derived, the bunching parameter derivation. Very similar to bunching parameter of two cavity klystron, just dash is removed, X is equal to beta I V1 by 2 V0 into theta 0 is the bunching parameter of two cavity klystron amplifier, where we want to find out V1. So from which the V1 is equal to, what is the formula? 2V0 X dash by, so beta I beam coupling coefficient of the cavity by DC round trip transit angle. So theta 0 dash is the DC round trip transit angle. Now substitute V1 here in this formula, electronic admittance. So therefore ye is equal to, so 2 beta I 0 into j1 of x dash by, so what is v1? 2 v0 x dash into beta I theta 0 dash will go to the numerator, into what is the phasor? E power minus j pi by 2 minus theta 0 dash. So we further simplify it as, write I0 by V0, which is called as DC beam conductance. Now, so beta I square, theta 0 dash by 2 cap, keep it as this, or 2 can cancel out also 2. So J1 of X dash by X dash bunching parameter. So this is what? So e power j pi by 2 minus theta 0 dash, simple derivation. So this is very, very important question in the examination. So therefore, so this is the electronic admittance of reflex klystron, where this is DC beam conductance. So therefore, so this is further written as, what is admittance is written as conductance plus susceptance. So this is written as conductance plus susceptance. Conductance plus susceptance, because admittance is always equal to conductance plus susceptance. Now here, one more important, here theta 0 is what? DC round trip transit angle. So as we have derived this answer, so which is the, what is the condition? So n minus 1 by 4 into 2 pi. So this is the condition which we have to maintain for the oscillations. So this is further replaced by capital N, 2 pi n. So this is another very, very important formula of DC round trip transit time. So what we have given in the previous derivation, n is any integer, capital N represents mode. If you substitute n is equal to 1, we get 3 by 4. So if you substitute n is equal to 2, we get 1 3 by 4 mode. If you substitute n is equal to 3, 2 3 by 4 mode, like that. So in which, what is the dominant mode? So the dominant mode is for n is equal to 1 3 by 4. Why? Because this has high efficiency, where we can get high power out of this mode. N is equal to 1 3 by 4 is the dominant mode of reflex klystron, which generates high power and also which has high efficiency. Now let us come to this equivalent circuit of reflex klystron. The equivalent circuit of
reflex klystron is given as, so you can see this, the equivalent circuit of reflex klystron, you can see this. So they, it consisting of an inductor, capacitor, because it is an oscillator, so therefore, so the what is the oscillator equivalent? Tank circuit L and C. So this is G suffix C, G suffix B, so G L, and the voltage across this is V2, and the, what is the current induced? The current induced is minus beta I beam coupling coefficient into I2, fundamental component of current I2. Why? Because negative, the current is flowing in negative Z direction, that we, that's why this minus sign is used. So therefore, what is here L? L and C are energy storage elements. Energy storage elements, as you know that, energy storage elements, because it is an oscillator, equivalent circuit is represented, it is L and C. So GC represents copper or conduction losses in the cavity. C indicates copper losses or conduction losses of the cavity. GB represents beam loading conductance. GL represents load conductance. So therefore, what is the total conductance? The total conductance is given as G is equal to, what is the parallel combination? GC, because they are parallel, add GC plus GB plus GL, so which is also equal to 1 by RSH. Conductance is equal to 1 by resistance. So therefore, where RSH is equal to effective shunt resistance of the cavity. One more condition we have to write here is that the negative, see here, this GE here, one more condition we have to be right here, the magnitude of negative real part of, the magnitude of negative real part of admittance must not be less than total conductance. So this is the very important point, total conductance, to maintain oscillations in the cavity. So that, what is the condition we have to create right here? So therefore, the negative magnitude of negative real part, so this is the, what is the real part? J. Magnitude of negative real part is this, must be greater than the total conductance G. So this is the, also you have to mention this point, to maintain the oscillations of the cavity. So now, finally you see one more parameter. So this is, you can see this expression, theta. So therefore, this admittance, so what is the admittance? Conductance plus susceptance finally. So this is in exponential form. This is exponential form where if you plot this admittance in rectangular form, so this will be formed into a spiral. If you plot the admittance YE in rectangular plot, so this axis is GE, this axis is BE susceptance, this axis is conductance, positive conductance for minus JE, negative conductance, susceptance, positive susceptance, imaginary values. If you plot the admittance in this polar plot of this, so it represents a spiral like this. So therefore, what is the admittance diagram? Admittance diagram is a spiral. You can see that theta 0 dash. So if you increase the angles, the spiral keeps on increasing, theta 0 dash, according to this formula. So theta 0 dash is equal to 2 pi n r. This is also written as, sometimes if you multiply with 2 pi, so this is written as 2 pi n minus pi by 2. So you have to represent this spiral. So one more point you have to observe in this spiral. I have written a dotted line here. So you can see this, for the angles of theta 0 dash for which the spiral lies to the left of this dotted line. So for those values of theta 0 dash for which the spiral lies to the left of minus j beta jb, for those values of theta 0 dash only the oscillations will occur. So therefore, if the area of the spiral lies to the left of this dotted line, for those values of theta 0 dash only the oscillations occur. So this is another important point from this spiral. You have to draw this diagram also. So because the admittance is in the form of a spiral, because it is in exponential form, so it is in exponential form, so therefore it represents a spiral. So this is what all about the electronic admittance of reflex klystron. Thank you.